You could say that the internet is kind of like a 4D, 5D experience, because the sort of defining quality of a three-dimensional reality is separation. Imagine what it would be like if I knew what you were thinking. When you're hungry, I can feel your hunger. When I'm hungry, you can feel my hunger. And when you look at it from a fifth dimensional perspective, it doesn't preclude the third dimensional response, like where you begin to not see the other person as other. This idea of dimensionality. So there is this current way of talking about how we are experiencing life, particularly at this point on the planet. And you will hear people say, oh, I'm moving into a 5D consciousness. So you have 3D, 4D, and 5D. So the way I like to think about it is, three-dimensional is what we experience and what we learned in science class. It's 3D. We've got up, across, and in the middle. We've got three dimensions. And maybe the fourth dimension is time. And so we can talk about dimensionality from a scientific point of view. We can talk about it from a mathematical point of view. Or we can talk about it from a spiritual point of view. I'm mostly using the spiritual model here, and I'm just pulling on models of the as they have been laid out by other people. But I like to use it because I find it's a very useful way to think about life, but also to think about angels and fairies. So when we talk about our three-dimensional world spiritually, the sort of defining quality of a three-dimensional reality is separation. You and me, us and them, up and down, binaries and multiplicities. This allows us to experience other people and other things as separate from us. And it presents as our primary reality, as sort of our first port of call and the thing that is most real. And it allows us to also have a very, very hard, a very sort of, unelastic experience of time. So we think of the past, the present, and the future. So these are very, concrete or very, what I like to call very dense perspectives. As you move into the fourth and fifth dimension, this idea of time and separation begins to break down. And we all experience fourth and fifth dimensional things every day. You could say that the internet is kind of like a 4D, 5D experience, because what it does is it breaks down our sense of separation, and we can all be plugged into the same thing and have the same resources at our fingertips. So let's say I was just listening to somebody talk about this the other day. As we move forward in our technological revolutions that are occurring, one of the possible outcomes is that we're going to have self-driving cars. And because of the change in what's happening in our financial institutions, we might have cryptocurrencies. So, and artificial intelligence, which means that theoretically we could have self-driving cars that take themselves to the gas station and to the mechanic shop and don't have human owners. And all we do is simply order them on our phone. They take us to our destination and drop us off, and then they take care of themselves. And we pay through a cryptocurrency that doesn't go through the banks or a middle person. So that we're all kind of in a matrix where the power lives with the individual and doesn't have to pass through a mediator or a centralizing force, because everyone is plugged into the same set of resources. So that's a sort of fourth and fifth dimensional understanding of what it might be like to live in a with three-dimensional resources. But when we talk about five-dimensional experience, imagine what it would be like if I knew what you were thinking all the time, and I knew what you were feeling all the time. Let's say you were really angry because I did something, and then you came and punched me in the face. If I was at a fifth dimensional level of awareness, I would know why you were punching me in the face. I would also feel the emotions that were driving you to punch me in the face. I would experience everything that you were experiencing. There wouldn't be a sense of separation between your emotional experience. I would have access to it. So if that were the case, and it were happening both ways, it would be very difficult for me to be angry at you. And it would be also probably very difficult for you to be angry with me. And if you did have those feelings, we would immediately know why. So if you imagine that you live in a world where there isn't that sense of separation, I feel you on a visceral level. I understand you on a visceral level. I'm connected to you. All I have to do is think about you to know how you're doing today. All you have to do is think about me to know how I'm doing today. When you're hungry, I can feel your hunger. When I'm hungry, you can feel my hunger.
You enjoying this so far? Did you forget to subscribe? Make sure to do so. It takes 2 seconds. Just press that little button, the red one. You know the one. Just press it, little like. All right, enjoy the rest of this content.
That kind of level of connection dramatically changes the way we treat one another. It basically takes our sense of separation and erases it and replaces it with a sense of integration. What this means, the repercussions of this are vast. It would completely change the world in which we live. We would view each other in very different ways. Our behavior towards one another would be different. And on and on and on. I mean, once you think about it, it's like opening a really lovely Pandora's box of what's possible. So the idea and currently is that we are ascending from a three-dimensional reality into a fifth-dimensional reality. But if you look at it on a sort of here and now perspective, we all have 5D experiences. So let's say you're very close to someone, be it a best friend, a parent or a partner, there'll be moments where you've had, I know what they're feeling. Let's say you have a child. Sometimes parents know when their kids are hungry because they actually feel hungry, even though they've just eaten. So these types of connected experiences that we have are 5D levels of consciousness, or where, for example, someone has an idea about something and maybe they begin to describe it to you, but because you have a connection, all of a sudden you go, I know what you mean. And they don't have to fill in all the blanks because you're able to sort of access the idea that they have in mind. A really great way of thinking about this is, let's take a popular novel. Let's take Harry Potter. Many people have read it and many people have gone to the movies to see it. And whether or not they loved the movies or they didn't love the movies, you would say that mostly people who go and see the movie, who've read the book, feel that there's a congruency between the novel experience and the film experience. There's some level of congruency, obviously because they're using the story to generate the film, but visually there's something that's also congruent that you're picking up on. So you could say that when you read a book written by J.K. Rowling, she had images going through her mind as she was writing the book, and then she was describing them in words. When you read her words, because we're all connected in our wonderful, like, universal internet, her words inspire the connection. So basically what you do is you tap into that sort of cloud of visuals that she was seeing when she wrote the book, which is the same cloud of visuals that the people who created the film were tapping into when they were creating the movie. So although there'll be things that you'll say, well, I didn't like that, or that's not how that character looked in my mind, but generally there's an overall congruency. That is another fifth dimensional manifestation, or something that comes out of that ability to connect at that level. Which is why when a lot of people read books, it's not just the words and the meanings and the thoughts and the themes, et cetera, that go into the understanding and experience of a novel. You're also kind of tapping into the person who wrote it, the images and the visceral experiences that they were having and putting into the novel. The reason that I bring this up is because our five-dimensional reality tends to be how we think of our spirituality. So a really great way of thinking about this is, again, going back to the smack. Let's say you get smacked by someone and from your perspective, it was unfair. Like they had no right to hit you, right? I've had experiences that are a little bit more dramatic than that, but we'll keep it to a smack and we'll use the smack as that example. I got smacked. And from my point of view, it wasn't fair that I got smacked. And I could say to myself, I had a choice where I could say, all right, I'm going to make sure that everyone know that I got smacked, make sure that the person who smacked me is held accountable for their actions so that they don't smack someone else, and then go and get therapy for my smacking because I was violated. And that would come, you would say, out of a victim consciousness, and not necessarily calling it victim in a negative way, but calling a spade a spade. So you could say it would be important for the person who smacked me to be held accountable for their actions. It would be important that, you know, we live in a safe world and that actions are taken to ensure that people just don't get smacked, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. That would be a very third dimensional response and a very responsible one, and ones that the vast majority of us might say, yes, this is the action that should be taken. And then when you look at it from a fifth dimensional perspective, it doesn't preclude the third dimensional response. Like, I might need to protect myself, or it would be wise that people are held accountable for their actions. It doesn't preclude that. But in order for me to move past it so that I'm not remaining at a victim consciousness, I then go into a fifth dimensional perspective, which is to say, how did I attract that into my life? Not that it was my fault that I got smacked, but what in me, what resonance in me brought that into my life? Now, in that moment, I am not saying that what happens on a three-dimensional level is unnecessary, but I am going to this other place where I'm sort of claiming responsibility for my life. And it takes me to a different level of understanding, because at that level, I am stepping away from being in a victim consciousness and saying, I'm going to accept responsibility for my life. But I also have to shift my perspective on the person that smacked me. And I start to see how I might have attracted them into my life. What am I learning from them smacking me? Like, it might be, maybe I'm learning that when I vibrate a certain way, I attract a certain type of energy. But I also might be learning that I am having compassion for the person who's smacking me, because their smacking is also coming from some place that might be difficult for them. So they just don't smack for no reason. And by virtue of doing that, I'm accepting responsibility for myself. I'm beginning to shift my perspective on the other person. And in order to really allow myself to forgive them, I have to begin to see them in the way that I'm seeing myself. In that we are both coming from a place of being vulnerable. We're both having this experience of life and trying to maneuver through it. And at that moment in time, them smacking me seemed to be, even if they knew it was wrong, the thing that needed to happen. So that sort of shifting, where you begin to not see the other person as other, and you begin to take responsibility for what's occurring in your life and incorporating that person into your worldview. In other words, seeing how we're interconnected and how my fingerprints play a role in their action toward me, begins to sort of change the paradigm. It stops being me and the other and starts becoming us. So that's the difference between one of the ways in which I like to delineate 3 to 5D.
If you like this content, make sure that you like, subscribe, and comment below. And we also have amazing link right there for some cool product. I know you want to check it out. I know you want to click it. Go ahead. Come on. You can do it. All right. Until next time, have a beautiful, blessed day.